Well, this ain't our usual time of leaving. The sun's setting, not coming up.
No, the sun's setting, but you know, it's one of my favorite times. That mangrove night bite is probably one of the most fun fishing you can do.
It is. Parker's got the boat loaded up, ready to go.
That's our boy. Let's go get him. All right, G, sunset and we're headed west.
Gonna have a pretty sunset look on the ride out. We're riding out to about, what, 70, 80 feet or so?
Yeah, it should be real good this time of year. It's in the fall. You know, the big mangroves, they move in closer this time of year.
Well, you know, we roll in the dark.
Fish don't sleep.
Nope.
We're gonna turn the Furuno radar on, keep it safe, look at Fleer, have a nice ride out. It's a flat pond. See if we can get on them.
Let's do it.
Yes, sir.
Pulled up this spot. I mean, look at it. I think there's some mangroves down there waiting on us.
Yeah, I would say we haven't even put a piece of bait in the water yet, and they are already sitting under our boat. It is loaded.
20 feet down.
Yeah, I think it's about to get tight right here real quick.
It looks like they're waiting with their mouths open down there. Let's go fill them.
I'm ready to feed one.
Let's do it. You get out there at night, and the stars, I mean, they just pop because there is no light pollution around. Don't have to worry about getting sunscreen on, getting burnt, drinking all that water. It's kind of a calming fishing trip.
Yeah, nighttime is definitely one of my favorite times to fish. You know, all the species of fish still bite just as good, and the sun don't take it out of you, and you can have a really productive night. All right, guys, so one of the tricks of this free lining for mangroves at night is to keep slack in your line at all times. These fish are super finicky. So we kind of just try to keep feeding the line steady. Don't hold tension on the line. Basically what you're doing, you're just feeding it down there. It's a natural flow with the current. And then when you get a bite, you'll always know it. It starts really stripping off. And from there, it's just flip your bail and set the hook. There he is.
You got him? There we go.
First bait. Boom, gone. Broke the line.
Broke it?
Yeah.
He hit it and run with it or?
Not really.
Yeah. Come on. Good mangrove. A lot of line out. Hope you don't get me in the bottom. Gonna be our first one in the box. I hope so. This is what we came for.
Target acquired right there, G. Nice, nice fish.
They like a light line, which can be tricky because they can get you in the bottom quick and cut it. Just using 30 pound right now. Daytime, you gotta move it down to 20 a lot of times, but. First victim of the night.
I'm on. There he is.
Ooh.
Gotta get him off the bottom.
Better get him.
They make their big run.
Oh,
There he is.
There you go, nice.
Nice double up, first couple baits down. At nighttime, man, these mangroves really bite a lot better than they do in the day.
They show up to eat at night for sure.
You know, we catch a lot of these during the day, but nighttime's definitely the best time, and it's fun out here at dark. Yeah. The sun ain't out beating on us, no sunscreen. Life's good, big mangs coming over.
Two nice ones.
Even though we're fishing the same places at night we fish during the day, it's almost like a whole different world every time we're there.
It is. One of the things I like, kind of like, don't like, is you know, the shadow, them lights cast over the boat. You don't know what size fish you have until it's coming up over the rail.
For us, you know, fighting the fish, you kind of know what you have on because we fought so many and you can tell, but there is always that what if, what's coming over.
One thing's for sure, the bites always fire at night. He's on it.
Good one. He's been at it.
Oh, he's close to the structure. There he is. Yeah, that snapper bob.
There he is. Nice one.
There we go. Another nice mangrove. He just bit up a chunk of sardine.
Yeah, he did.
Another nice nighttime Crystal River mangrove. Once you get up to these bigger mangroves like this, we like to bleed them. They got a lot of blood in them, big bloodline, and it sure don't hurt to take the flay knife right inside that gill there and cut it, bleed them out a little bit. It makes it better in the long run for sure.
So freelining is a technique that we use during the day, but at night it seems to work a whole lot better. The fish are coming up off the bottom more.
Yeah, you get away with a lot heavier leader. You know, daytime, you're trying to stick around 20 pound leader. At night, you can get away with 30.
It definitely makes your catch ratio go up a lot. And when you do hook that fish, that, you know, the unknown fish, your chances of landing it is a lot higher.
Yeah, and we're not running a chum bag either, you know, with a small piece of bait. I mean, we were freelining big old pinfish back there, trying to hand pick the bigger fish.
Yeah, and the quality was there.
Absolutely, it was.
There we go.
Uh-oh.
That's a good one.
That's a good one. There we go.
Nice mangrove snapper.
Good one.
Nice 3-4 pounder on the free line. They're biting a little bit deeper tonight. I think a little bit of a cooler weather.
Kind
of pushed down.
Not much current, you know. I'm not feeding this line out quite as much as we're, you know, used to. Usually the current's ripping and you're having to feed it out, but I'm just barely easing it out.
Hey, it's slow, but it's not slow once it finally gets there. They're biting it, nice ones.
Big thing is you got to know when to put pressure on them and, you know when to give a little. They got a lot of slack out, so you got to reel it up quick because he knows where that bottom is at.
There he is.
So not as much current, little slower bite. Just takes longer to get it back there. Bite's really not slow. Thank you.
So one of the main concerns is safety. You know, people always ask us, well, you're running in the dark, and you know, whether we're running in or out, it's always a big concern. And why is that not a problem?
Well, because one thing is we have the best radar there is on the market. That Furuno 25 kW radar, I mean, it'll pick up a crab buoy out there in flat water. Which luckily it was flat that night. And on top of the radar, you know, we used a FLIR too to help navigate.
Yeah, so that's definitely, you know, an extreme safety for us. It's always nice to have them electronics in our back pocket, keeping our clients safe, our family, no matter who we got on the boat.
I have 100% confidence running that boat at night.
Little mango. That's my favorite eating size.
I know, those are the best. So coming out here at night, you know, I wasn't completely confident, you know, we're gonna get into the mangroves good.
Yeah, you know, it being winter, but I tell you what, the tides turned and we really got on the fish. It was like every single bait we sent back, you know, we were catching the quality we were looking for. I mean, all of our fish were 3 to 5 pounds tonight.
They were all good fish. We definitely had a nice catch.
That's a good one there, G.
Yep. He's headed to that bottom.
Hardest thing you can go.
He knows what to do.
That 30 pound leader, boy, yeah. It's light.
Yeah.
I think what now?
It's gonna be a good one here. I mean, a good one.
I don't think I can boat flip that one. Let's try it. Oh yeah.
Ooh.
That sucker was trying to get home.
Yeah. Nothing like trying to catch a mangrove the size of a red snapper.
I don't think that's a mangrove. I think you can get to call that one a black snapper.
That's a black snapper.
He has long eluded his mangrove days.
He's got a few different names. Mangrove snapper, black snapper. Depends what region you're in. South Florida, they call him a mango. Gray snapper.
This is what you can expect right here on a night trip, guys. Big mangrove snapper all night. Probably a 5-6 pound fish right here. Definitely quality and a lot of fun.
Big one for the Gulf of Mexico. Another good one here, Laramy. Ooh, I don't think I'm gonna stop him.
Stop him.
I don't know. That 30 pounds got all at once.
Woo! Uh-oh. I think you done found Mr. Grouper.
Got me. Oh, man.
I think you hooked something that you couldn't bear there, bud.
We ended up losing a few fish. You know, once that free line got so far back, they kind of got the upper hand on you if they do eat it.
Yeah, whether it's day or night, they still know where the bottom is, and you're gonna lose them, you know, but the main thing is turn the handle and try to pull up on them as much as you can, you know. We're only using 30 pound leaders still at night, but you gotta get after them.
Yeah, you can only put so much pressure on them, but sometimes we maxed it out.
You wanna come back, he got him. There he is.
There we go. I lost my battle. See if you can win yours.
I think I got a big mango. Got that snapper bob going. They biting here, buddy.
I think mine got eaten by something bigger.
Yes, sir. Another nice mango. Oh, let's see.
Oh my gosh.
Another black snapper there, bud.
You can pretty much plan on retying every time you get one that big.
Yep. Another quality one out here.
Another good one.
It's fun to get them suckers up, boy.
Let's see if I can get this one up.
Uh-oh, here we go. Another big one.
Thank you. think I won the battle, but not the war. I got him. Straight dirt.
Ooh, we getting them, boys.
Nice pair right there.
I love night fishing.
It's called double fisting gangsters right there. Black snapper, Crystal River, Florida. Nighttime, come get you some.
You better get with them when they bite, buddy, because they are going to that structure. You don't win every one, but they met their match.
Yes, sir, they did. These are going home. They're going to be some tacos. One thing is for sure, the winter fish are a little bit more lethargic. We didn't get them quite as high in the water column tonight.
No, we didn't have a whole lot of current either, which I definitely think played a part in it.
There's all sorts of little bitty things that went into it, but man, once you did finally get it down there pretty close to the bottom, 20, 30 feet, it was smack city.
There we go, that's a big bank.
A little bit easier to pull in than the last fish. Here it is, nice big quality mangs. You know, a lot of people worry about coming out here at night, but we have pretty much everything you need for the tip-top safety. We have a FLIR, we have a Furuno radar. It lets us know of any objects, you know, even within 12, 15 miles. Usually we run at about 3 miles for safety. But you can come out here, you ain't gonna be out here all night. The sun ain't beating on you, and fishing's good. Y'all should come get you some of this action.
I know I catch a lot of flack from you about the jig, but I actually had a pretty hot run going.
You know, jig fishing for mangroves in the daytime usually don't go that swell, but at night it was like every single drop.
Night or day, you know, the mangroves are tough on a jig. I don't know exactly why that is, but like I said, I had a pretty hot streak going, and it's always fun to find another way to catch them.
Yeah, and it was very productive.
Come on, stay hooked. Don't be a jet. He's acting like it.
No? Just a mango. Nice mango on the jig.
Old jig got him in the dark. I had to put an extra set of hooks on there. I kept missing them.
You know, with this nighttime fishing, you don't have to be a professional angler. You know, you can be a beginner, friends, family. You know, at night, you have a lot of double, triple, as many rods as you can run. They all get bit at night.
Before you know it, you know, you get out there fishing at dark about 8 o'clock, and it might be 1 o'clock in the morning next time you look at your watch. You know, I mean, time flies out there at night.
The good fishing makes that clock tick a lot faster.
There he is.
Good one there.
Yep.
That's one to end the night on right there, buddy.
Knew this spot was gonna be good when we pulled up and the Furuno was lit up. Look at them. Boy, is that two nice ones to end it on or what?
Dude, I mean, it has been a killer night. We have been smoking them. Every single bait down's been a bite.
Yep.
Well, dude, it's been a killer night out here.
Been quality mangroves all night long. I mean, look at that. That's two nice mangroves in the night on.
I couldn't be happier with how it turned out. Yeah. Our fishing out here is incredible. I mean, if you guys want to come get in on some of our night action, come check us out. We have a lot of fun. It's great for family, friends, company trips. Quality fish like this in the dark, don't bring your sunscreen.
I think anybody would enjoy it, man. If they're interested, look us up, ffcfishing.com, and we'll be more than happy to put you on these fish.
All right, G, you about ready to end this night?
I've heard that once or twice in my life.
G, I'm about ready to wrap up the night on this one right here, buddy. G, I'm about ready to wrap up the night on this one right here, buddy.
Let's see it.
Got the mangrove candy right here, Mr. Grunt. See if we can end the night on him right here.
Run, you.
Well, gee, this is my last bait of the night right here, bud. I'm about ready to go home.
All right. Let's see it.
Ah, see if he comes back for it. I think I still got him. Motherfucking Let's do it again. All right, gee. All right, end the night.
Yeah.
This is getting out of hand. There you go, G. Gonna end it right here?
I don't know.
You need to get a picture with it.
I think that's a good way to end the night. God bless. Well, G, this is my last bait of the night, bud.
Yeah. Catch one, put them in the box. Ha ha.